Greetings, everybody. We continue our journey through Advent, and I was reflecting on my favorite Advent hymn, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. And this song is actually almost 2,000 years old, believe it or not. It is based on some of the most ancient liturgical texts that still survive from the earliest centuries in the masses of the early Christians. And December, starting, what is it, about 8 days before Christmas, on December 17th, every day in the liturgy of the church, there is what is called an O Antiphon. These are part of our rich history and rich tradition that exists in our beautiful church. And the O Antiphons were used two times, and still are, two times for 2,000 years. Isn't that cool? First of all, during, of course, the daily Mass, the O Antiphon is the refrain between the Alleluia verse. The second time you see it every day during Advent between December 17th and Christmas is the antiphon of the Canticle of Mary in Vespers. And you know that Vespers, all priests and religious out there in the world, the monks, the nuns in monasteries of men and women across the whole world, seminaries that pray the Liturgy of the Hours, and many parishes do as well. Vatican II encourages everybody, the laity included, to pray the Liturgy of the Hours. And right after all the psalms, kind of there's three psalms, and then there's a reading, and then there's a responsory. And then at that moment is the Canticle of Mary, where every single night of the whole year, the church remembers that Canticle of Mary. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. The church, every night, we chant that very canticle. And right before it and right after it is an antiphon. And during these special days of Advent, as we near Christmas, starting on the 17th of December, the antiphon is one of these incredibly rich texts right out of the treasure trove of our tradition. And the O Antiphons are an injunction to God, O come, O wisdom from on high, who order all things mightily. To us the path of knowledge show, and teach us in her ways to go. Rejoice, rejoice. And that would be on December 17th. December 18th, O come, great Lord of might, who to your tribes on Sinai's height in ancient times once gave the law in cloud and majesty and awe. And then every day the church gives us one of these images where we invoke the Lord, please come, please come. You are the source of all wisdom. You are the source of all might. You are the key to our life in heaven and even our life on earth. You are the root of our life. All of these different injunctions, and they're beautiful, all leading up to that last one, which happens to be the first verse in O Come, Emmanuel. O Come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile here until the Son of God appear. And so, friends, these antiphons are so rich, so important in our tradition. It really would behoove us all, I think, to spend a little bit of time in prayer each day, starting on the 17th, each day reflecting on the antiphon of the day. And I'll have a worship aid, just like I did last year. I think I put them out in the pews or something, put them in the bulletin or something, where had each one of the antiphons for those days, just as a resource for your prayer. I guess I'll end with, I have a little bit of a cold, but I'm going to sing it for you anyway. Oh come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel. Isn't it something to think those very words have been chanted by the whole church for 2,000 years, this longing, this desire for God with us, for Emmanuel to be with us and in us. God bless you all.